guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm gonna be filming my Sephora haul from the Sephora sale that is going on. So if you don't know, Sephora has a sale 2 times a year and the sale is going on right now. There are 3 different tiers, and if you haven't signed up, I mean, what you doing? Okay, you need to go and sign up for the Beauty Insider program. Beauty Insiders get 10% off, VIBs get 15% off, and VIB Rouge gets 20% off. And I believe the sale ends November 7th, which is Monday. It's Thursday as I'm currently filming this. So I just got my order in today, so I'm gonna go ahead and show you guys what all I got, okay? I feel like this is like my biggest haul. I don't really know, but it feels like a lot of stuff to me. So let's just go ahead and jump into it. I have everything laid out in front of me, so I think I'm just gonna go in order because I put them into, like, you know, little categories. So I think I'm just gonna go in order, you know, of how I have everything laid out. So we're gonna go ahead and start with skincare, okay? So the first thing that I got is the Glow Recipe Guava Vitamin C eye gel, because I needed an eye cream. Eye gel cream. I need an eye cream because I don't currently use one, so I wanted to try this one. I will say this is little. Like, I thought it was gonna be bigger. You know, she's kind of small, but that's okay. So I got that. And then I picked up the Fenty Skin Cookies and Clean like face mask. It looked really good. I wanted to buy it sooner. I just didn't have the chance. Let me see. I'm gonna open it. Ooh. I don't know. It smells like mud, but you know, that's okay. It's just a face mask. Okay, it's not supposed to be anything special. So I picked this up. I picked up the Youth to the People vitamin C and caffeine serum. I also don't use a vitamin C yet. I have tried a couple, but I wanted to give this one a try. So I grabbed that. And then I got this new oil. I had never seen this until like recently when I was picking out stuff in my cart. This is the Merit Great Skin Instant Glow Serum. And I think it has niacinamide and hyaluronic acid in it. And first of all, I like the packaging. It looks fancy, okay? But then I think you have to shake it because you can see it's like separated in there. So you have to shake it. And yeah, just another face serum. Then I got the Dr. Dennis Gross Daily Peels. I love these. So I tried like the small pack that had like 5, and I was like obsessed with these. So I went ahead and got the big pack during the sale because this is expensive, okay? These are expensive. So I had to wait for the sale to grab them. But love these. They're so good. And then I needed a new cleansing oil. I prefer cleansing oil over a cleansing balm. So I just picked up this one from Caudalie. This is the Caudalie Vino Clean Makeup Removing Cleansing Oil. I was using this Shiseido one before, but I ran out. So I grabbed another one and I just wanted to try something different. There's nothing wrong with the Shiseido one. It's nice, but we're gonna try that one. Then I picked up the Dermalogica Daily Microfoliant. This is the full size. Honestly, this should last me forever, okay? Because the little one, like the mini size, lasts a really long time. It all just depends on how much you use. So you know, if I use this sparingly, this should last a long time. But I like to use this and I do use it every day. Last in skincare, I picked up this Freck Cactus Water Toner. This is big. I thought it was gonna be smaller or maybe like taller. Maybe it seems big because the jar is fat, but it's a nice like a glass jar. Like, this feels like a fancy toner. Let me see how you get it out. Okay, so it just has like the little hole at the top, so I can just, you know, pour it on the cotton pad or in my hand or whatever. So I like the packaging of this. It's fancy. Like, it just, you know, it's aesthetically pleasing, okay? I like it in a little glass bottle. So that's it for skincare. Not too much, but you know, we're gonna be trying out some different things. I did pick up a couple of brushes. Most of them are from the Sephora collection, which is 30% off. So I did grab a few of those. This is the Sephora brush number 93. This is a blush brush. So it's just an angled brush, and I love these kind of brushes for blush. They just apply blush like perfectly. Okay, the next brush that I got, this is brush number 78, and this is a contour brush. I thought it was gonna be bigger, like I thought this part was gonna be bigger, but it should work fine for blending out contour, I think. Not like I don't have other options, but that's a low contour brush. And then I picked up this foundation brush. This is brush number 70, and this is supposed to be for like full coverage, okay? Like you can see how dense this brush is. Like the bristles are not moving at all and they're really short. So this is supposed to give me full coverage. And then I grabbed another foundation brush. This is brush number 64, and this one is for sheer coverage. So if you see the difference between the two, these bristles are a lot longer. They're not as tightly packed as they're not as tightly packed as this brush. So this one should be for sheer coverage, which is what I prefer most of the time. But you know, every now and then we'll do a little full coverage. And then I picked up the Rare Beauty concealer brush. Babs Beauty talked about this brush, so I wanted to give it a try. I actually have a couple of things in here because of Babs Beauty. Love her. So she recommended this brush, and let me see. Oh, it seems like it'll be nice for blending out concealer. It's like a triangle type shape, so it can just get like right up in there. Yeah, okay. So that will be nice. So those are all the brushes that I got. Next, we're gonna move into perfumes. I picked up the Maison Louise number 4. Maison Louise Marie number 4 perfume, the Ballancourt one. And I got this because I picked up the travel size last year. It smells so fresh. I picked up the travel size last year, and my like rule of thumb is if I go through a travel size, then I'll go ahead and purchase the full size, because I have not quite a few, but I have some roller balls up there and I haven't like used them all, but if I use them up, then that means I like it, and so I'll get the full size. And then I got a travel size in this perfume. This is the Mugler Alien Goddess. I've never smelled this one. Okay, it smells good. Ooh, it smells good. I forgot what the notes and stuff are. God dang, my nose is burning. It does smell good. That smells really good though. Yeah. I don't remember what all the notes are, but I remember when I read the notes, it seemed like it was going to be something that I liked. So I went ahead and grabbed it. And the little bottle is pretty. So we got that. Okay. Oh my goodness. So much perfume. Now we're going to get into the makeup portion. Okay. Okay. So the first thing that I got is the Huda Beauty Easy Bake Loose Powder. And I have this already, but I have this shade Kunafa or something. I don't know. So I got the shade Blondie, which is like lighter, just to see if I can get, you know, a little bit brighter, because I like the powder. It just seemed like that shade was a little bit too dark. So we're going to try Blondie. And then another Huda Beauty product is her concealer. A very long name. It just says Faux Filter Concealer on here though. So I picked that up. Let me see if this color is going to be okay. I think it should be okay. I got the shade Brittle. Is that what I got? Yeah. Brittle 6.5G. So I got this concealer, which I've heard good things about. And then I picked up the LYS or Liss, contour stick. Oh my gosh, how do I open it? Ooh. Look at that. That looks pretty. So I picked this up. This is in the shade Courage. Oh my God, I feel like I'm gonna like ruin it. Yeah. I've heard good things about this, and this was pretty affordable too. So I grabbed that. Another Babs Beauty recommendation was the Sephora blushes. This is in the shade Flirt It Up. I didn't open this. Let me open it so I can see what the color looks like. So that looks like a really pretty, nice pink color. Mm-hmm, that's cute. Okay, and then I just picked up another one of my favorite brow gels. This is the Refi Brow Sculpt. That, like, my brows are, like, glued on, okay? They're not moving. And that is my favorite brow gel. You do have to be careful because it can leave a cast in your brows if you put too much. So, just be careful. What else? What is this? This is the Laura Mercier Secret Camouflage. Hold on, y'all. Secret Camouflage Brighten and Correcting Duo. So, this is just, like, a concealer stick. Oh, this on there tight. I don't want to ruin anything. What side is this? This looks like it's the concealer side. Or the brightening side. Maybe this is the correcting side. I don't know. I can't tell. Does it say? Hold on. Yeah, okay. It says. It says. So this is the correcting side and this is the brightening side. And I picked this up because I thought this would be good just to spot conceal my face. Especially on days where I don't want to wear foundation, just, you know, just plop this on. I think that would be really nice. Okay. Something else I picked up is the Hourglass Unlocked Instant Extensions Mascara. First of all, I love this gold bottle. Bottle? Is this a bottle? Gold tube? I don't know. I love it. It's gold. So it's pretty. So yeah, here's the wand. I don't know if it's focusing because I cannot see, but yep, just another mascara. I love mascara. Y'all know I don't like to wear false lashes that much, so we need a good mascara. I did pick up a foundation. This is the Dior Forever Skin Glow foundation with SPF. This is the shade 4.5W, and it just looked really nice. I have the Dior Backstage, which I wear all the time, so I figured I would try this one. I'm trying to watch the children. And then I picked up two primers. I picked up the Iconic London Underglow Blurring Primer. So it looks like it's got like a tint to it. Ooh. Yeah, it looks like it has like a, like you see that? Like a nude tint. So that'll be interesting when I put it on my skin. I don't know. But I saw someone on TikTok use this, so I grabbed it. And then another Babs Beauty recommendation, I picked up the Glowish Blur Jam by Huda Beauty. She recommended this, so I'm gonna try it out. Oh my goodness. It looks weird. So yeah, we're gonna try this out. We're gonna try it out, and it comes with a little like scoopy thing, but honestly I hate these little things. Like I'll just go in with my nail, even though I don't like to do that either, but I'd rather do that than use these little scoops. Another makeup product that I picked up is the Natasha Denona Biba palette. Is that what this is? Yeah, this is the Natasha Denona Biba palette. It's a neutral eyeshadow palette. First off, let me say you don't need it, okay? You don't need it. The price is ridiculous. But I've had my eye on this palette for years, you guys, and I could never justify the price. And it's not like I don't have, you know, plenty of neutral eyeshadow palettes, but this year I was just like, whatever, man. Let's just get into it. It's so pretty though, y'all. Like, it's so pretty. And I mean, it really is. It's just neutral eyeshadows. And for the price, honey, you don't need this. You don't need it, but I've been wanting it for a long time. So I just went ahead and got it. It's dirty. Okay, so we still have a little bit of makeup, but this is all lip products. I separated the lip stuff on its own because I did pick up quite a few lip products. So let's get into those. Ooh, the first thing that I picked up, I got this Pat McGrath Lust Gloss Set. So it came with both of these full-size glosses for $30. So I thought that was a pretty good deal. This is like a coral color. Looks like a nice corally pink color. This is in the shade Wicked Whisper. And then it came with this nude color, which is Faux Real. Let me see. Yeah, they look pretty. The color that I want is out of stock, and it just don't ever be in stock, y'all. So I just went ahead and grabbed this little duo so that I could at least give them a try. Then I picked up, this is the Mario like plumping lip serum. Ooh, it clicks. This is in the shade Honey Glow. And it's just like it's clicking. It's just, oh my God. It doesn't go back down. Oh, ho, ho. Did I smash it? Hope I didn't smash it. No, I didn't. Okay. Yeah, in the shade Honey Glow. So that looked pretty, so I got it. And then I got a Tower 28. What are these? Lip jellies? Lip jelly gloss. This is in the shade Cashew. I do have this already in the shade Oat, I think. I think I got Oat. I want to get a couple more shades of this. But these are really good. Really good lip glosses. And then I picked up the Fenty Skin Cherry Treat Lip Conditioning Lip Oil Stuff. Another Babs Beauty recommendation. Like, look, honey, this video is sponsored by Babs Beauty, okay? Ooh, it smells good. You know what it reminds me of? It reminds me of Lip Smackers. Do y'all remember those? Do they still make those? Yeah, it reminds me of Lip Smackers. So pick that up. One more Babs recommendation. I picked up the Too Faced Hangover Pillow Balm. Yeah, Too Faced Hangover Pillow Balm. And this is the original. They do have scents. And this is a big, like a fat tube. I thought it was going to be skinny, you know, like a little like lip gloss. But it's a pretty fat tube. Let me see. The original has a little bit of a scent, but not really. So I picked that up. Then I picked up the Fresh Sugar Advanced Therapy Lip Recovery Mask. Oh, this has one of those things too. I don't like it. So this is just a nice little lip mask that I'll probably put on like at night and stuff. So just a lip mask. And then I picked up this Makeup by Mario Perfecting Lip Scrub. I needed an exfoliator, so I picked this one up. I've tried oh my God, it looks like a lip gloss. I ain't see no beads or nothing in there. I don't know, we'll give it a shot. But I've tried quite a few exfoliators, so it's just something, I haven't found one that I'm like, oh my God, that is, you know, my ride or die and I'm gonna use it forever. I just keep trying different ones. So this is the one that we're trying right now. And then the last product in this haul, I picked up the Patrick Ta Major Volume Plumping Gloss. And this is in the shade 2CCs. And it's just like this cute little pink color. Ooh, that's going to be super pretty. Ooh, and it smells good. It smells like candy. Smells so good. Oh my gosh, I cannot wait to use that. Okay. So that's everything that I got this year for the Sephora sale. This is the only order that I'm placing, y'all. I'm not buying nothing else, okay? This was enough. This was, you know, this was plenty. So yeah, stay tuned for the next video because I'm about to go and demo all this makeup, okay? Let me see what time it is. Yeah, I'm about to go and try on all this makeup. So keep your eye out for that video. Thank you guys so much for watching. Go sign up to be a Sephora insider if you haven't already. And if you've already shopped the sale, let me know what you got. Let me know what your recommendations are, okay? So I can be ready for next year because I only shop at Sephora during sale time unless there's a drop that I feel like I really need or I've run out of a product that I really like. Other than that, I only shop twice a year, honey. So leave your recommendations down in the comment section, and I will see you guys in the next video. I'm excited about all this stuff. I cannot wait to try it.